We're going to end with a song. It's a song. Most of my music is about things that that happened to me or things I know about firsthand. But this song isn't. It's about a guy I've never met, but I think I understand him. Everybody alive, I think, is very much looking for some kind of feedback, some proof of his own existence, hopefully some positive one. We all find ways of getting it. I get up here periodically and make an ass of myself. President Nixon is president and makes an ass of himself that way. Some people join the swimming team or have 15 kids or the best bridge player on the block. I don't know anything. But this guy really, mostly because he's stone cold crazy, but partially because of the way he grew up and partially because of our society, really doesn't have that opportunity. He's sort of literally John Lennon's nowhere man. And one morning he wakes up and with a perversely sensible logic decides to grab for maybe half a day of glory instead of a lifetime of nothingness. And we've had guys like this for about the last 10 years in our national life. It seems every couple of months. It started, I guess, with Medgar Evers and Malcolm X, and then the Kennedys and King and Wallace. There have also been non-political ones. There have been ones such as Essex and New Orleans recently. This one was about a guy on a campus, but it's really about all of them. It's sort of a strange song to sing. I guess Gapin' Chapin lives again. It's a strange place to be inside, but hope you understand what we're trying to do. It's called Sniper.
She said, not now. She said, not now. She said, not now. She said, not now. It is an early Monday morning. The sun is becoming right on the land. No one is watching as he comes a-walking. Two bulky suitcases hang from his hands. He heads towards the tower, stands in the campus. He goes through the door and starts up the stairs. The sound of his footsteps, the sound of his breathing, the sound of the silence, but no one was there. I did not really know him. He was kind of strange. Always sort of sat there. He never seemed to change. Oh. Oh. Catwalk, he put down his burden. The four-sided clock began to chime. 7 a.m. The day is beginning. There's so much to do and so little time. He looks at the city where no one had known him. He looks at the sky where no one looks down. He looks at his life and what it had shown him. He looks for his shadow, it cannot be found. He was such a moody child, very hard to touch. Even as a baby, he never smiled too much. She said, you're ugly, she said, please hug me, I said, but she just sat there with the same flat stare that she saves for me alone when I'm home. He laid out the rifles and loaded the shotgun, stacked up the cartridges along the wall. He knew he would need them for his conversation. If it went as he planned, then he might use them all. He said, listen, you people, I've got a question. You won't pay attention, but I'll ask anyhow. I've found a way that will force you to answer. Been waiting to ask you till now. Right now,
right now,
am I am a lover who's never been kissed. Am I am a fighter who's not made a fist. Am I, if I am alive, then there's so much I've missed. How do I know I exist? Are you listening to me? Are you listening to me? Am I? The first words he spoke took the town by surprise. One got Mrs. Gibbons above her right eye. Blew her through the window, wedged her against the door. Reality born from her face and staining the floor. Just once, that was all. Bill Whedon was questioned as he stepped from his car. Tom Scott ran across the street, but he never got that far. Police were there in minutes, they set up barricades. He spoke right on over them in a half-mile circle in the dumbstruck city. His pointed questions were sprayed. He knocked over Nanny Tyson as he ran towards the noise. And just about then the answer started coming, sweet, sweet joy. Thudding in the clock face, winding off the walls, reaching up to where is that their answering call. Thirty-seven people got his message so far. Yes, he was reaching them right where they are. They set up an assault team. They asked for volunteers. They had to go and get him. That much was clear. And the word spread about him on the radios and TV. In appropriately sober tones, they asked, who cared if... coming to get me, they don't wanna let me stay in the bright light too long. It's getting on new now, it's going to be so now, but oh, what a wonderful song. Mama, won't you nurse me? Rain me down the sweet milk of your kindness. Mama, it's getting worse for me. Won't you please make me warm and mindless, Mama.
yes, you have cursed me. I never will forgive you for your blindness. I hate you. The wires are all humming for me, and I can hear them coming for me. Don't ever hear, but there's nothing to fear. Not anymore, they'll be blasted the door. As the cop to drop the gas, he shouted, who cares? They could hear him laughing as they started up the stairs. They stormed out on the catwalk, blinking at the sun. With their final fusillade, his answer had come. Oh, am I? There is no way that you can hide me. Am I? Oh, you have put your fire inside me. Am I? You've given me my answer. Can't you see?